Hi, I am Maker Giovanni and welcome back to my channel. This is a Shelly RGBW and it cost 30 euros. But what if I told you that you can build the same product for as little as 3 euros? That's what we will see in this video, but first let's take a step back. I recently decided to put an RGBW LED strip on my wardrobe to create this beautiful lighting effect. Once I bought the LEDs, I needed a controller so that I could connect them to Home Assistant. Instead of buying a pre-made one, I built it from scratch to see how much money you can save with DIY, and the answer is a lot. So today we are going to see how I built an RGBW LED strip controller connected to WiFi and therefore controllable from Home Assistant and from your smartphone, spending just 3 euros. In addition, I also added a temperature sensor, a brightness sensor and two motion sensors to the controller, so that this one device can replace many different smart devices, making us save even more money. These sensors can be used in the Home Assistant automations. For example, using the motion sensors, I created one to automatically turn on the LED strip as soon as I entered the room, setting a different brightness based on the time of the day. Obviously, for the automations, the limit is imagination. But now, let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. JLC PCB is a professional custom printed circuit board manufacturer that makes high-quality PCBs from 1 to 8 layers starting from just $2. Ordering PCBs is very simple. Just go to the JLC PCB's website, upload the Gerber files and select different parameters to preview the PCB and proceed with the purchase. Once the order is placed, the production of the PCBs is very fast and can be done in as little as 24 hours. Right now, a promotion is running on 6-layer PCBs, with $30 coupons with which we can purchase multi-layer PCBs for as little as $5. This is the LED strip I mounted on my wardrobe. It is a 12V RGBW LED strip, which works by connecting a common positive and giving the negative to the red, green, blue and white channels to create the different colors or every white light. Along with the LED strip, I also bought a power supply, so the only thing left is to prepare the controller. The controller must be able to control in PWM 4 output for the 4 channels of the LED strip. To do this, I bought on AliExpress these 4 modules that have MOSFETs on them. The MOSFETs will allow us to control the LEDs which consume several amps from the pins of a microcontroller that can be an Arduino or, as in this case, an ESP8266. I chose this module because it has a Wi-Fi connection, which allows us to connect it to a network to control the LEDs from, for example, a smartphone. It may seem strange, but this is all we need. So for the components, we spent just over 3 euros. Now we can assemble everything. The PCBs with the MOSFETs have 3 terminals on one side, for positive and negative of the power supply and for the load, and on the other side they have ground and the input to connect to a pin on a microcontroller. To make the connections between the MOSFETs, I 3D printed the holder to keep the PCBs aligned. With wires from which I removed the sheeting, I connected the positive and negative and GND of all the boards. By mounting the boards in this way, I was able to keep the wires neater and also improve the cooling of the MOSFETs. At this point, I connected the cables to the PWM input of each board, as well as to common GND. I connected these cables to the ESP8266, using pins D4, D3, D2 and D1 for the red, green, blue and white channels. Then I move on to the power part, and connected the LED strip connector to the 4 MOSFET outputs. To connect the power supply, I cut a piece of 2-pin cable, which I soldered to the positive and negative of the MOSFETs. To the positive, I also connected the common positive of the LED strip, which counterintuitively is the black wire. Lastly, we are left to install WLED on the ESP8266, to finally be able to turn on the LEDs. It was here that I ran into an error that I didn't know how to solve. The next day I found a mistake. I connected the MOSFETs to pins D3 and D4, which when brought to ground do not allow the ESP8266 to boot. Fortunately, fixing the issue was easy. After moving the connections to other pins, the WLED installation worked great. Once WLED was configured, everything was ready to plug in and it works. By connecting to WLED's IP address, I can control the color of the LEDs or set them to white. At this point, I would just need to 3D print a case for the ESP8266 and MOSFETs, and for less than 5 euros I would have a fully functional RGBW controller with the ability to connect it to Home Assistant or Alexa. It was at this time that I had an idea. As we already have a microcontroller connected to Wi-Fi 24 hours a day that controls the LEDs, why not also use it for other functions, such as measuring room temperature or detecting motion? Usually when creating a smart home we always use many different devices. For example, we have the controller for the LEDs, the temperature sensor, the motion sensor and so on. As we add devices, the cost goes up, and the power consumption also goes up, because we must remember that inside each device there is a microcontroller that is always powered. So I thought of adding to the LED controller that I built a temperature and humidity sensor, a brightness sensor, and two PIR sensors to detect motion. In this way, with the power consumption of only one microcontroller and a very low price, we have, in addition to the LED controller, all the sensors that we need to control a room with automation using Home Assistant. The first sensor I worked on is the motion sensor. First, I designed and 3D printed a case in which to mount it. Then I took a 4-pin cable, cut a piece of it and routed it through the hole in the holder. I soldered the cable to negative, positive and output of the motion sensor. Then I glued the sensor and closed it up with its cover, which fits snugly onto the base. To be able to orient the sensor, I designed a ball joint on the back, into which you can insert a base to put on a table, or as I did, a stand to mount the sensor on top of a closet. Against all odds, the mechanism for orienting the sensor, although entirely 3D printed, works really well. Lastly, I crimped the JST connector to the end of the cable, using for the first time this cool tool I gifted to myself last year. Finally, here's our sensor ready, and here's another one with a slightly longer cable. Now that the motion sensor is ready, I moved on to the temperature sensor. As a sensor I chose an SHT31, which is very accurate. In addition to temperature, it also measures humidity and communicates with the microcontroller using the I2C protocol. This sensor is also extremely compact. Just consider that the actual sensor is that little black square, just 2.5 mm wide. Also, for this sensor I cut a piece of 4-pin cable, which I soldered to positive, negative, SCL and SDA of the sensor. The sensor will be hidden behind the edge of a cabinet, so to keep it as compact as possible I did not make an enclosure for it. As before, I connected the GST connector to the cable, this time with 4 pins. Now we are left with the light sensor. Here I went with a BH1750, also working with the I2C protocol. The connections are the same as for the temperature sensor, so here is the sensor ready. While making the sensors, I realized that the ESP8266 does not have enough pins to connect everything, so I upgraded to an ESP32, which has more pins and a generally better processor. Now that we have all the sensors, we need to make the circuit to which they will be connected. First, I cut a piece of paperboard, onto which I soldered the ESP32 and some GST connectors. The connectors will be used to connect the two motion sensors, the temperature sensor and the brightness sensor, the 5V power supply and the MOSFETs to control the LEDs. The connections are very simple. All sensors receive ground and 3.3 volts power supply. The two motion sensors have a digital output, which I connected directly to two pins of the ESP32. In contrast, the temperature and brightness sensors use the I2C protocol, so they are connected to pins 21 and 22 for SDA and SCL with pull-up resistors. The MOSFETs are connected directly to the ESP32 pins, and I also provided a connector for the 5V power supply. I made the connections under the board, and here is the result. Before completing the project, we need to program the ESP32. To connect the ESP32 to Home Assistant using Wi-Fi, I chose to use the ESP Home integration. The configuration is very simple, and once completed, we can control the LEDs from Home Assistant and use the status of the sensors to create automations. As always, since talking about the software is a bit boring, if you are interested in the Home Assistant configuration, I will leave a detailed written guide with also the files to 3D print and wiring diagrams in the description below. At this point, I designed and 3D printed a box to install all the components. Before mounting everything in the box, we need to make the last connections. First, with a JST connector, I connected the MOSFET to the board. Then, while for testing we could power the ESP32 with a USB cable, in the final installation it will have to be powered by the 12V power supply of the LEDs. For this I used this small 5V voltage regulator, and once connected I could finally mount all the components in the 3D printed box. Lastly, I connected all the sensors to the board, and closed the lid with threaded inserts and M3 screws. Now we just need to do one last test, 3, 2, 1, and again everything works, both the LED strip and the different sensors. To mount the LED strip on the wardrobe, I used some aluminum profiles, which I cut to size to follow the shape of the wardrobe. On the aluminum profiles I glued the LED strip, using this simple jig to keep it centered. The LED strip segments are connected together with some wires. I placed everything on the wardrobe, and for power I used an outlet I had set up for exactly this purpose before assembling the cabinet. As for the motion sensors, I mounted one on top of the cabinet and one on the window. For the temperature sensor, I put it behind the edge of the cabinet, to make it completely hidden. I turned on the LEDs and the effect is really nice, especially in the evening. However, turning on the LEDs from our smartphone every time is not what we want to do. Instead, it would be very nice if they turned on automatically as soon as we enter the room. This is exactly why I mounted the motion sensors, because with a simple automation I was able to make the LEDs turn on as soon as I entered the room, and I am detected by the first sensor. When I sit at the desk I am detected by the second sensor, which keeps the LEDs on as long as I stay in the room. The automation also turns on these hexagonal lights that I built last year, while if the sensors don't detect anything for 5 minutes, the LEDs turn off. The automation I made is also based on the time of the day, so that during the day the LED strip doesn't turn on since it is useless, while when it's night the brightness is very low so that it is not annoying. Obviously, for automations the only limit is imagination, so if you have any other ideas for automations, write them down below in the comments. And so this project ends here, and as always I hope you enjoyed it. If you are interested in electronics, check out my channel, and maybe subscribe. Bye, and we will see you at the next video.